Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namam Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Nitinamine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Desatarine He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneswari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Pyevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo 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 Mahabhadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratvase Nama Sri Nilachala Nivasaya Nityaya Paramatmane Balabhadra Subhadravyam Sri Jagannathaya Te Nama Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
First of all, I want to pay my respectful obeisances at the lotus feet of my spiritual master, Sri Srimad Gaur Govinda Swami, Srila Gurudev. And also I want to pay my respectful obeisances at the lotus feet of ISKCON Founder Acharya His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj. Paying my obeisances at the lotus feet of Sadhu, Guru, Vaishnava and Acharyas. And also I want to pay my respectful obeisances to the Vaishnavas assembly here. By the mercy of Sriman Mahaprabhu and Sriman Nityananda Prabhu.
This is the most essential teachings in Vaishnavism, specially in our sampradayas, in Gaudiya sampradayas. Our Siddhant is based on Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 11th canto, everywhere. Sukadeva Goswami always mentioning how a sincere disciple should develop his service attitude towards spiritual master. Like in 7th canto, Prahlad Maharaj giving same instruction. Guru Sustrusaya Bhaktya Sarva Labdharpananam cha Sangino Sadhu Bhaktanam Isura Radhanana cha Tatra upaya sahasranam ayam bhagavata uddita. Narad Muni mentioning to Prahlad Maharaj, and Prahlad Maharaj mentioning same statement to demanding boys. Tatra upaya sahasranam. Many confusion came also in our Vedic literatures, when some, even scholars people, they are reading so many literatures, still they are in confusion. How to achieve perfection in our life. same Vyasadev mentioning different procedure and different methods in different Puranas. Sometimes someone worshipping, if he directly worshipping Krishna, he can get Krishna Prams. Also mentioning there. But what is the secret? Key point. Tatra upaya sahasranam ayam bhagavata uddita. Many saintly persons, they are giving many ways. How can we get liberation, perfection in our life? But ayam bhagavata uddita. Prahlad Maharaj mentioning, what I am just speaking to you, that was I am Bhagavata Uddita. This statement is coming from Narayana Rishi. This is not my statement. I am Bhagavata Uddita. Many procedures are there, many methods are there in Puranas. Don't fight with each other to see the Puranas, to Shastras. Because different Shastras, conclusion is different. But I am Bhagavata Uddita. Prahlad Maharaj is Mahajan. What he is mentioning, I am Bhagavata Uddita, this is statement of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Tatra Anjasa Bhagavatarati, easily how can one develop love towards Krishna, this Prahlad is giving. Then first statement is coming from Prahlad's mouth, Guru Susrusayam Bhaktya. Sarvalabdharpananamcha. What is the duty of a disciple? Guru susrusaya bhaktya natu pratishta adina. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur mentioning, you have to serve your spiritual master with devotion. Not for name, fame, prestige and adoration. Same thing Prabhupada mentioning in his purport. Sarvalabdharpananamcha. Whatever you have, everything is belongs to Guru and Krishna. We are reading Bhagavad Gita, Sarvadharman Paritejya Mamekam Saranam Raja. We are teaching to others also. Sarvadharman Paritejya Mamekam Saranam Raja. Then what is our duty? We are teaching to others. Our duty to give up everything for pleasure of Guru and Krishna. This is also Sarvadharman. You cannot say this is mine. Nothing is belongs to us. Nothing. Whatever this body, whatever you have, everything is belongs to Guru and Krishna. This is Krishna's gift, Lord's gift. You cannot say this hair is belongs to me. Your hair is not belongs to us. It will fall down. It turns to grey color. You may paint it, but you cannot say, oh, it is mine. It will fall down. What you have? Nothing. Only falsely we are pushing. I am the owner. I am the owner of this land. I am the owner of this country. I am owner of this place. Everything belongs to Krishna. Any lesson will take place. Everything, what you are seeing now, everything, finished. This is fact. We are not artificially creating some detachment. Many people, they are thinking, oh, these saintly persons like sadhus, they are creating disturbances where they are not allowing anyone to enjoy in this world. What is enjoyment? Whole life you are suffering. Maya is giving heavy losses. Just one day drinking wine, eating meat, going to some park, this is enjoyment. This is enjoyment of life. Suffering whole life, crying. Day and night everyone is crying. We can say in English, there is no shelter for a conditioned soul. No shelter. Which is our shelter? Those devotees now in Krishna consciousness, just compare their life. Before Krishna consciousness, what was their position? In the Mangalore, shelterless. You see, like street dogs in the street. Prabhupada used to always giving this example. Dogs moving in the street, always look to someone, he looks to his face. Why? Why? He want master. He's shelterless. No one giving shelter. You see, the moving dogs, street dogs, everyone going without any cause giving abhilashes. No shelter. No food. Whole world without Krishna and Krishna's devotee. Just like shelterless. Our life is like that. We are suffering. And same question, Sanatana. There is no need of asking any question to solve our life's problem. Everything is mentioning in Shastra. Just we have to accept it. In our procedure, we are not creating anything. Why I will chant Hare Krishna? Before you asking, already talented persons, knowledgeous persons, they already ask these questions. There is no need of asking any questions. But only one question you have to ask, how can I perform devotional service in my life? Just ask this one. Other things already, learned persons already asked. There is no need of asking these questions. How can I deliver from this material world? From clutch of Maya. Maya is already, how can we trapped? Entrapped. Everyone. In Oriya people are saying, I don't know here people are saying or not. Uriya people, they are saying, Baba, I am in Maya. What is in Maya? They are suffering, but they have no power to give up their family life. Son is not liking. Daughter is not liking. No one is liking, but still they have same attachment towards his family. He is suffering, but no power to give up this thing. Entrapped. This is Maya. A false conception is coming. False idea is coming. To enjoy, enjoy. There is no enjoyment. What is enjoyment? The life is full of suffering. One enjoyment is there because we are spirit soul. Spirit soul can enjoy spiritual blissness. That is here. Enjoying. Kirtan, Krishna Katha, Prasadam. This is enjoyment. Bodily enjoyment is only suffering. Only itching. Prahlad Maharaj Singh, like itching. Itching in English? When itching? No, when you feel itching, looks so nice. For 5 minutes, 2 minutes. Then you'll cry. Kanduina dukkha dukkham. Trupyanti neha kripana bahu dukkha vaja. Perfect example. No one can defeat. Everyone is crying. Once I was in one Bhagavad Katha, I was staying in someone's office in Orissa, village area, in forest of officer's office. There was one book, Michael Jackson, Life History of Michael Jackson. I bring that book. Who is Michael Jackson? I want to study. I hear before. What is Michael? What was his duty? What was his singer? When he sing, everyone dance. But I just study his life history. How he was dancing? How he was dancing when his wife going to court? How much billion dollar he pay for a divorce? Then when I read this one, I say, oh. When he's singing, everyone dancing. Now you see how he dancing, his wife is just make him dance. Everyone saying, you know, I am enjoying Michael Jackson's song. And he's enjoying in court. This is material world. Just like itching. Everyone is suffering. Only one enjoyment is there, spiritual enjoyment. Because we are spirit soul. We are searching for happiness, happiness, happiness. This is happiness. Maya already entrapped us. How can we free from Maya? What is the way? What is the way? Sanatana Goswami asking this question. How can I free from Maya? I know this is false conception. There is no happiness. Nothing else, only suffering. But I have no power. We have power? No. We know what is good. We know what is good, but we cannot do. We can't do it. We know what is bad, but we have no power to give up it. We are saying, I am great. This is our greatness. What is good for us, we can do it. And what is bad for us, we cannot kick it, give up it. This is our power. Everyone is saying, I am great. This is your greatness. This is your greatness. Where is our greatness? When a conditioned soul is captured by Maya, finishes, life is finished.
ताते कृष्णा भजे करे गुरु रसे बना ताते कृष्णा भजे करे गुरु रसे बना माया जाल छुटे पाए कृष्णेर चरण माया जाल छुटे पाए कृष्णेर चरण
ऑल सिद्धांतस यू कैन फाइंड इन चैतन्य चैतामृता. Unless you study Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can't find out Siddhantas. All conclusions from Srimad Bhagavatam, the essence of conclusions you can find in Chaitanya Charitamrita, especially in Rupa Goswami's teachings and Sanatana Goswami's teachings. Sanatana Goswami, such a learned scholar, is asking this question, how a conditioned soul, he can get liberation? Maya, he is suffering from past life, many life he was suffering. Maya already entrapped him. He have no power to give up Maya. In name of enjoying, he is suffering. In name of enjoying, only suffering. Tati Krishna bhaje kare guru ra sevan Maya jala chute pae Krishna ra chara. Straight answer, two things. We have two job in Krishna consciousness. I don't know in English how can you say. In Oriya there is one budget. Now election is coming. Before election, no, इसको हिंदी में बोलते हैं ना काम चला budget. काम चलाने के लिए एक budget करते हैं. I don't know in English how can you say. Workable budget. काम चलाने के लिए budget करते हैं. Our life is like that. Material life means workable budget. In Uriya, we can say, when people are suffering, they say, why you are worried? This, we are coming to this material world for 2.5 days. We are coming to this material world, to this world, for 2.5 days business is going on. And within the 2.5 days, you see how people is just like suffering. 2.5 day business. Actually, 2.5 day means 1 day business, a half day business. 1 day we took bath and 1 day death. 2 days fixed. And a half day business is going on. And within this half day, everyone, you see, everyone is crazy, easy, lazy, busy, everyone. Someone wants to enjoy, and then lastly, crazy. And someone wants to earn money, busy. And someone can't enjoy anything, then he is just lazy. Yeah, this is material world. Just workable budget. Have the business. Even you may have some daughter, whatever you are, big factories, but you will stay for half day. Don't worry. You can't stay forever here. Even you have $100 million, still you can enjoy only 2-3 chapatis. Not like Bhimsen, you can eat 1,000 of chapatis. Enjoyment is already allotted for you. Fixed amount of enjoyment. This is illusion. Don't think if you earn more money, you can enjoy more. No. This is false idea. Suffering and enjoyment, everything is already allotted you according to your destiny. You have faith or not? I can prove you. I can prove you. You see, the millionaires, they have big, big flat, big, big car. But when diabetes will come, doctor said, you can't eat chapati. You have to walk 2 hours. Take little food. Where is your enjoyment? You have everything, but you cannot enjoy. Because enjoyment also already alerted. And suffering also alerted. Everything is alerted to you according to your karma. There is no need of separate endeavor for enjoyment. What is that verse? Jatha dukham majatnataha. Prahlad Maharaj's teaching. Sukham maindriyakam daityam deha yogena dehinam sarvatra lavate daibat jatha dukham majatnataha. You can challenge. You cannot challenge it. Bhagavatam. You can say, if I will not try, how can I enjoy? Now these young guys, they have this idea. They know. My friend already married, he's suffering. He said, no, I will try. You will try. Knowledge, if someone is very intelligent, he can acquire knowledge not by seeing, by hearing from Shastra. What Shastra is saying? Shastra is called I. This is our real I. What Bhagavatam is saying? You may try forever. Sukham indriyakam daityam dehe yogena dehinam. What? In which body? Now we are in human species. If you go to animal species, any species. Sukham indriyakam daitya deha yogena dehinam. O demonic boys. Because demon boys, small boys, they want to marry. They said, Prahlad, you are saying to chant Hare Krishna, but we are very small, we want to marry, we want to enjoy. He said, don't worry for that. It is available in any species. Enjoyment will come according to your destiny. If you try, it will not come. Don't think, this is illusion. If you try, it will come more. No. Sarvatra lavate daibad jatha dukham ajatnat. Just like no one is trying to get distress. Anyone is trying? Okay. 5 months I am living very nicely. 1 month I want distress. I want to go to medical. Anyone trying distress? Anyone inviting danger? It will come. Everyone wants to avoid danger. But why danger is coming? You are not inviting. Just like danger is coming without your invitation, happiness will come. There is no need of special attention, special care for that. Bodily happiness and distress, it will come at a particular time. Without endeavor. But without endeavor, you cannot get one thing. What is that? Krishna bhakti, without endeavor, you can't get it. You can get wife, service, everything, money, material happiness by your destiny. But because already, you perform some pious activities, it will come. Just like in postal, speedy post. You already book something, it will come. Don't worry for that. There is no need to go to every station. You book for Orissa in Bangalore, there is no need to go to Andhra Pradesh again asking, where is my letter? There is no need to ask. It will go. So material happiness will come. And distress will come. Don't worry for that. But one thing, it will not come. You have to do. What is that? Krishna bhakti. Therefore, we should lead our material life in workable budget, minimum budget. For half day, we have to stay here. Don't make some permanent arrangement. Big house, big car. Useless. This is special for devotees. Karmi people, they can't understand it. But devotees, too important business. Because we are already entrapped by Maya. We are suffering here. We know what is Maya. People don't know. We know what is Maya. Still, we have no power to give up. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving two nice formula. Tate Krishna bhaje kare guru rasevan maya jal chite paaye krishna ra charan. Unless in this life we can't achieve Krishna's lotus feet, there is no other way, no other way. Tate Krishna bhaje, this is our first duty. Tate Krishna bhaje, we have to chant Krishna's name, we have to serve Krishna. This one is first principle. And second one, Guru Rasevan. We have to serve spiritual master. How can we serve Krishna? Through spiritual, two ways. This is Mahaprabhu's teachings. Serve a saintly person, a sadhu, and chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This is the way, this is the remedy in our material life. This is the only medicine. To serve spiritual master and chant Hare Krishna and serving Krishna. But even we are devotees, sometimes we can see in our devotee communities, because most of the devotees are here, we are discussing for devotees, not for outside peoples. But we have no, how can you say, eagerness, intention, a strong desire to serve spiritual master and also to serve Krishna. Like our Gurudev used to say, we are ill-fated. One term is there, because mostly I am hearing and I am speaking, I don't know its meaning also. Like I am not very expert in English. I am not so educated. We are ill-fated. Hindi mein kya bolte hain? Durbhaga. Durbhaga. Such a great chance is there, but we are misusing. Ill-fated. If someone is a human being, and second one is civilized, and third one is astik. How can you say in astik? Pious person. And fourth one is devotee. And fifth one is initiated. After getting this five chance, still he is not developing a strong desire to serve Guru and Krishna. He is ill-fated. Just like you are coming to the last doorstep, but you are missing something. With such a great care, you coming there. Due to our pious activities, we are coming here. It is not easy to become a devotee. Not at all easy. What are that words Vasudev mentioning? Bhaktisto bhagavata bhakta sangena parijayate satsanga labhate puman sanchitei purvasikrutei. Satsanga labhate puman sanchitei purvasikrutei. If someone has previous sukrutis, pious activities, only he can get satsanga. It is not available for everyone. You can see nearby the temple, many people are there. They don't like temple. They like club. Because they have no pious activities. They can't come. They don't like this thing. But 30 kilometers, 40 kilometers devotees are coming. They have sikrutis. If you have previous sikrutis, this is the result of previous sikrutis. Krishna will arrange sadhu sangha for you. We are ill-fated. Such a great chance. So why our eagerness is not coming? How to serve more and more? When someone earning money, he feel tired? Anyone feel tired when he earning money? No one is saying, okay, this is enough, I don't want to earn more. No one is saying. If someone is saying, then he is actually fortunate. No one is saying this is enough. No one is saying enough. We want more. Prabhupada used to say money. Brighter than sunshine, sweeter than honey. Prabhupada,
In Bhagavatam, our Gurudev is always used to say this one. Money, 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 whole world is now crazy. A ghost is already, how can I say, entered to everyone's body, money. Like ghost enter into your body, you are not in proper consciousness because ghost is now acting. Everyone is like a ghost. With that ghost, money. From morning to evening, bus, ghost is entering. But for a devotee, he should focus on two things, Mahaprabhu's teachings. Tate Krishna bhaje kare guru rasevan. Why am devotees? This is my duty, prime duty. Previous many lives, I have everything. I have wife, I have children, I have money, everything. But in this life, only two things I... By my previous sikrutis, I got two things, guru and Krishna. I will not miss this chance. I don't want to miss this chance. Last step from, how can I say, from this material world. We want to go to, like, therefore Prabhupada used to always show one finger, like that. One finger. You saw Prabhupada in BTG? Like that. What is that? Why you are looking towards Bangalore or UK or USA? Don't see here. Prabhupada will swing his finger. Go back to Godhead. So where you want to go? You want to go to UK, then you are studying. Oh, where is UK's tourist place? What is going on there? So what is our business? Where we want to go? To spiritual world. Then study books. Study the literature. Do the same business. What is going on in spiritual world? We are not belonging to this material world. Special devotees. But why this desire is not coming? Why desire is not coming? Why desire become not so strong? Why? And therefore, seventh canto mentioning, Sridhar Swami mentioning in his commentary, Srimad Bhagavatam, 10 characters are there. Every canto, there is some scare. First canto and second canto is called preface, like introduction. From third canto up to 12th canto, 10 characters are there. And 7th canto is called Uti. Uti, Utischa Vasana Prakta Tattat Karma Anusarinam. Uti means in Sanskrit Uti, and in it's called Vasana. Vasana means a desire. Material desire is coming. We know what is spiritual and we know what is material. We have power to distinguish it. But still, we can't give up material attachment. We know. And we have no power to increase our spiritual attachment. Why? Why this is not happening? Actually, we have no power. We have no power. We are powerless. We are minute particle. Especially this material world is full of Maya. Everywhere Maya. Everywhere. Enjoyment is there. And this mind is creating all problems. You understand? Who is creating problem? Mind don't like. Mind like material things. Mind don't like spiritual things. And due to this mind, we are coming to this material world. And mind playing such a, how can you say, heroic role, not heroic, villain, huh? Oh, villain. Very crooked role mind is doing. When you want to do something for Krishna Seva, I want to go to temple. Then mind says, why you want to go to temple? This devotee is not good. Why you want to go there? Oh, you want to go there? No, don't go to temple. Politics is going on. Material world is full of politics. In your house, politics is not going on? Between husband and wife, such a great politics. nothing you can't say this thing. Anywhere you can find such politics. You don't know, you are not married. But Bhagavata is saying, you don't know. therefore you are silent. Unless you become political in your material life, you will be defeated. What I am saying, Bhagavat Singh, I am not saying, Lord Kapil Dev, this is discussion between mother and son. This is discussion between mother and son. Gruhesu kuta dharmesu dukhatantresu vatandrita kurvan dukham pratikaram sukhavat manyate gruhi. This is Bhagavatam, none different from Krishna. There is no happiness in family life. You don't say, we are sadhu, therefore we are saying. Bhagavat saying, don't blame us. Don't blame us. Many people blaming us. They are not married. We are already married. But why they are not liking us? We are not saying. Bhagavat is saying. Gruhesu kuta dharmesu. Before you are simple, when you want to marry and enter to family life, you have to play a villain role, political role. Otherwise you will be defeated. Everyone will blame you. Always you have to play political things. Gruhesu kuta dharmesu dukha tantresu atandrita. You may be expert in all sort of activities, still you can only suffer. Only you will suffer there. Unless you serve spiritual master. Krishna bhaje guru rasevan. It is for everyone. It is not only for... That does not mean you will not marry, you will become happy. Whether you marry or don't marry. But our devotees have two business. Krishna bhajan and guru rasevan. Dukha tantrisu atandrita. You may be very expert, but only you will suffer. Is there any happiness? He said, Kurban dukkham pratikaram sukhavat manyate gruhi. Prabhupada in his translation mentioning, to successful counteract this distress is so-called happiness in this material world. This is Prabhupada's word. To successful counteract this distress, some distress is coming, problem is coming, successful you have to counteract it. That is happiness. Today you have some problem, you solve it, then you think, solve. Then next day start. This is life. Sukha bat manyate gruhi. Bat in Sanskrit, bat means like. Looks like happiness. Those are not married, that marriage life is very happy. Happy life, enjoyment life. Once they married, same darkness. Okay, if I have a child, then there is happiness. Then when child born, then same problem. Sukha bat manyate gruhi, one who attached to his family and not attached to Guru and Krishna, his whole life, it looks like happiness. In this material world, everything looks like happiness. There is no happiness. You may admit it or don't admit it, but Bhagavad is saying, we have to say, there is no happiness. In America, there is no happiness. Where is in India? Therefore, Prabhupada went to America. America is like capital of all world. American gin, American dress, American, everything is American. And Prabhupada went there and make hippie too happy. Now Indian become, before India peoples, they are, before they are happy, now they want to become hippie. All are hippie. You say in city life, they are just crazy. They will cry. No happiness. Only one happiness. Tate Guru Krishna, Tate Krishna bhaje kare Guru rasyaban. Maya jala chute pai Krishna racharan. Our business is not to marry or not. Marriage is life is our not business, or you even don't marry, this is not our business. Our business is go back to Godhead. It is for everyone, for brahmachari, for grihastha, for vanaprastha, for sannyas. This is our two important business who will protect us. Krishna bhajan and guru rasyavan. But why this desire is not coming? Even we know. Then utis chavasana prakta tattat karma anusarenam subha asubha cheti divida hetu bhedata. There are two types of desire coming. One is subha, auspicious and another is asubha, inauspicious. We know. I saw in Bangalore, I saw in India, how many temples are there? Small, everywhere you can find temples. Even karmi people, they are going morning and evening, they are going to temple. They are worshipping. But why, we are devotees, we know this is our only duty. But why strength is not coming? You don't think I am harassing you. But this is the only way, how to get more strength. Secret is here, only one way. We know, but we have no power to do it. We know everything is maya. Only duty is to perform Krishna bhajan. But why strength is not coming? No, a met conditioned soul have no strength to perform Krishna bhajan. Unless someone help him. Who can help us? Here, from here. Siddha Swami mentioning. Subha asubha cheti divida hetu bhedata. There is some cause. Someone developing his attachment towards Krishna and someone just losing his attachment towards Krishna. Why? And Siddha Swami mentioning.
Asubha cha subha cheti divhidasa hetu vedata asubham mahato kopat subha mahato nugrahat.
By our previous activities, previous sukrutis, we came to Krishna consciousness. But still in Krishna consciousness, we want some help. In Krishna consciousness, still two desires came. Is auspicious and inauspicious. Subha mahato anugrahat. If you serve Sadhu and Guru, if Sadhu Guru please with you, day by day, how can we say, your desire becomes strong to serve Guru and Krishna. Our strength will not help us. We have only material strength. You saw that thing is mentioning in Vishnu Bhajan.
Jogyata vichare kichu nahi pai. Tomar karuna sar jogyata vichare kichu nahi pai. Tomar karuna sar karuna na hoile kandiya kandiya karuna na hoile kandiya kandiya pranana rakhiba ro pranana rakhiba ro.
This is not for outside people, this is for devotees. Jugyata vichare kichu nahi pai tumara karuna sar. This is such a path. Only we can run our spiritual life, we can lead our spiritual life only by mercy. Here material qualifications, material strength will not help us. When we get spiritual strength, mercy from spiritual master, then we develop strong desire to serve Guru and Krishna. Unflinching faith will come. Strong desire will come to serve Guru and Krishna. Jugyata vichare kichu nahi pai. I have no other qualification. What qualifications we have, that is not for Krishna bhajan. That is not for Krishna bhajan. It will not help. But to lead my spiritual life, only one thing is required. What is that? Tomar karuna sar. Your mercy is the essence of my life. Therefore, even you see, karmi people, when they saw some sadhu, they are paying obeisances. Baba, please shower mercy. Even karmi people know the secrets. Immediately they touch your feet. Immediately they touch your feet. And saying, Baba, please shower mercy, shower mercy. Then once. Pitru deva bhava, matru. Mercy is everywhere. You don't think we are saying about guru. But even karmi people, they are worshipping their forefathers, their fathers, their mothers. They want worship. Even for their material progress, they want mercy. I saw in some Marwadi, most of the Marwadi shops, grocery shops, you saw in their shop, they are always putting their forefathers' photos. Why? This is not our sentiment. We are always saying about guru and guru, guru's mercy. This is not sentiment. It's fact. Even karmi people, you saw karmi peoples. Now in India, you don't find like your forefathers for photos. Huh? Now cricketers, film stars, naked lady photos, and dogs. But before, everyone putting their forefather photos. Why? To get mercy. They remind, father, you just help me. You are a pious person. Even in Orissa, we have this tradition. If he is a farmer, he makes his some father samadhi nearby the grain field. Why? Every day he will go to grain field, to cultivate land so that he can remind his father. Even karmi parampara that depend on mercy. We are devotees. Without guru's mercy, without devotee's mercy, how can we lead our spiritual life? Everywhere. Mercy is always required. Guru's mercy, Krishna's mercy, always required. Devotee's mercy is required. What happened in case of Shravan Kumar? Pitru Bhakta. Very devoted to his father. He got all mercy from his father. He was so talented, Shravan Kumar. He had such a power. And so devoted. You saw this picture. It was in before. I saw when I was a small child, I saw this picture. Nowadays you can't find. Only in Saraswati Shishu Mandir. Eh? In your country there is Saraswati Shishu Mandir? In your state? Saraswati Shishu Mandir. No, eh? Only in that school you can find all these pictures. A small boy with a long stick, with two basket, carrying one woman and one man. You saw this picture? Hey, Shravan Kumar. Hey, Shravan Kumar. And Dasaratha just killed him. And he's such a... You see, this is their mercy. He got father's mercy and he feeling severe pain. Still he's saying to Dasaratha, I'm not a Brahman. I'm not a Brahman, don't worry. You are a king. And my father is not also a Brahman. He's not an austere person. He's not a tapusi. You just go to my father and you inform him that you killed me. Because my father is waiting. Suppose I have to bring water. You just go there. And my father will not curse you. I told you, my father is such a person, he will not curse you. Then Dasaratha went. When Dasaratha went, because they are blind, father and mother is blind. Why he is carrying with stick? You know, father and mother told them, Shravan Kumar, we want to see the different tirthas. We cannot walk because we are blind. You may carry us. Son is carrying his blind father and mother to different tirthas. Even they are devoted to their father, mother. Who is your father? Your father? What is your father's name? No. You can't say your father's name now. Once you initiated, once came to Krishna consciousness, Guru Pita. This tradition is in Bengal. In Bengal, you go to Bengal, in our, in our court, this tradition is there. In our, how can you say in English? This law is there. If someone is initiated, according to Indian tradition, he is the owner of his guru's property. Guru Pita, our father is Guru. You cannot say my father's name is like that. In passport, it may be in Aadhaar card. But don't say to anyone, my father, he is my father. You have to say your guru's name. Then Shravan Kumar, Dasaratha Maharaj went there and informed. And his father was liking so much to Shravan Kumar. Just by hearing the sound of footprint of Dasaratha Maharaj, he is saying, oh my son, why you came so late? What you are doing? We are waiting. This is now time. You may just recite some Bhagavad, recite some verse from Bhagavad you want to hear. For his father's spiritual progress, they are blind, but son is reading Srimad Bhagavatam. But Dasaratha at that time, he already killed his son. Lastly, Dasaratha opened his mouth. He said, "No, I am not your son. I killed your son. Please excuse me." Then Shramad Kumar's father started to cry and said, I am not. Why are you killing my son? We are not harming anything. By fruit and root, we are maintaining our life. Why are you killing my son? What harm he had done? I know my son is very, very gentle person. Why are you killed him? And lastly, he cursed. You see, why I am telling this? Mercy have some power. Material qualification have no power. He liking his son so much, even he have power to curse Dasarath Maharaj. Why you killed my devoted son? I curse you. Because we are now suffering in pain of separation from our son. When you will die, you can't see your son's face. You can't see your son. And you will feeling the same pain. What now I am feeling? He calls. Why this was mentioned in Puran? Everyone have some mercy. Father have some mercy. Everyone. Demigod have some power to give mercy. And most powerful is the, how can you say, he's the owner of all mercies, Krishna. Source of all mercy. We are worshipping him and his devotees. Subha asubha cheti divida hetu vedata. Subha mahat kopat, subha mahat anugrahat. You can develop your strong desire to serve sadhu and guru when you get mercy from sadhu and guru. This is subha. Pure desire will come. But where devotees, but if spiritual hankering is not coming, have to serve more and more, have to chant more and more, have to please Guru and Krishna. That means asubha mahat anugrahat. Mahat kopat. Spiritual master, saintly persons, they are not pleased with me. Therefore, my desire is, material desire is increasing and spiritual desire is decreasing. This is the symptoms. If sadhu guru pleased with someone, his spiritual hankerings will increase day by day. If he is displeased with someone, then immediately material desire increase. Where is its proof? We are discussing about Ishwarpuri. And his god brother, Ramchandrapuri. Both are disciple of Madhavendrapuri. But Madhavendrapuri displeased with Ramchandrapuri. Because Ramchandrapuri giving instruction to Madhavendrapuri. When Madhavendrapuri in pang of separation from Krishna, just crying, he is giving instruction. Don't give instruction to spiritual master. What? You have to, as a disciple, have many duty. Unless Guru asks you something, you have no right to say something. And whenever you want to say something, with folded hand, first tat vidhi pranipatena, then no, first pay obeisances, then serve, then if Guru say you have something to ask, then you may ask. Otherwise, when Guru flees, first pay obeisances, you serve, you please Guru, then you ask. But our procedure, immediately we are going to go. Gurudev, why this is happening? Guru is your servant, he is bound to give you answer. You have no right to ask anything. Before, this was in first initiation in Prabhupada. People, devotees asking many questions. They are just sitting nearby the Prabhupada. Prabhupada giving all answers. And when Prabhupada first giving initiation, and Prabhupada saying four principles. No meat eating, no gambling, no intersection, and another, no illicit sex. And section round you have to chant. And serve spiritual master. Then someone rising hand. Prabhupada said, no. Now no more question. You are now disciple, you have no right to ask. What I am saying, you have to follow. Then both came, all the devotees came. Why Prabhupada, after initiation, why Prabhupada saying like that? Before he was giving answer. No. When you are a disciple, now you have to just follow. And if you have some inquisitive to ask, please spiritual master. You cannot advise spiritual master. If you are advising, giving intelligent or giving knowledge to spiritual master, that means you are spiritual master, he is your disciple. You can't say anything. Even proposal with, this is the duty of a wife and duty of a disciple. Both are same. With folded hand, serve nicely, then with a humble mood, you can say, Gurudev, I can do like that. What is your opinion? In English we are saying, what is your opinion? But we are already giving opinion to Gurudev. I want to do that thing. I want to marry. I want to this thing. If you decided, then why you are saying to Guru? You are already Guru. He giving only, Ramachandra Puri giving instruction. Why you are crying in separation of Krishna? Think about Brahma, think about Krishna. Then immediately Madhavendra Puri displaced. Ei aparadhetar basana janmila. Guru displaced. Yasya prasade nagati kutopi. Finished, spiritual life finished. And immediately Suska Jnani. Nindate Nirvandha. He was a devotee before. He was chanting. He was a devotee of a elevated version of Madhavendra Puri. But immediately heart became dry. Speculative knowledge came. And his nature to criticize other. Criticize mentality. Criticism and fault find. Gurudev used to say, these two things is not devotion. If someone always engages in criticizing other, he is not a devotee. This is symptom. To criticize other and to see the fault of other, this is not devotional life, spiritual life. No. Why Ramachandra Puri criticize everyone, and see the fault of everyone? Why? Guru displeased. Asubha vasana, immediately material desire came. He was criticizing everyone. Lastly came to Jagannath Puri. And he pondered Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at that time staying with some devotees. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw Madhavendra Puri, Ramachandra Puri paying obeisances, because he is my spiritual master's god brother. Never disrespect. Everyone knows he is a big fault finder. Sometimes he invited devotees, please come for prasadam. He bringing Jagannath prasadam, many variety of prasadam. And devotee said, no, please give little. He give more. No, you take it. Because if senior devotee serves someone, he cannot say, oh, his senior devotee is giving, I have to accept it. Ramachandra Puri giving more prasadam than necessary. Then after giving more prasadam, if a devotee will take, then he'll criticize you. I hear before, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's devotee is eating more. Now I saw practically. All Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's devotee is eating more. He feeding with love. Forcefully, then criticize. Everyone develop fearness towards Ramachandra Puri. Everyone. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is Krishna himself, and in devotee form, he's so nice. So humble, but always giving respect, always. And Mahaprabhu is very strict sannyasi, but he's coming to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to find some fault. But he never find any fault. He tries so much, every day he tries so much to find out some fault. But Mahaprabhu is very strict. Very strict. When Mahaprabhu know Ramchandrapuri criticizing about prasadam, Mahaprabhu said to Govinda, Govinda, I will take 1/4 of my meal from today. Before I am taking one meal, make it 1/4. Mahaprabhu take little. And everyone start to lament. Why Mahaprabhu develop so much fear towards Ramchandrapuri? Mahaprabhu very strict. Sanyasira alpa dosa sab lok gaya. If you wear red dress, if you make a little, how can you say? You create little disturbance or fault. Even it is not fault, people will say. Oh, he's a sannyasi, he's doing like that, he's doing like that. Like a white dress, if a little black spot is there, it became prominent. Sannyasi life is like that. Mahaprabhu very strict, he don't find any fault. Ramchandrapuri try. Lastly he came. He saw ants are moving in this room. Ants. Chinta bolte hai na? Ants are moving. Then he start to shouting. Oh, in night time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is eating sweets. Otherwise, why ant is moving here? He's such a great front wilder. You understand what is its philosophy? What is tattva? If you see, if Guru displays, you will see the fault of everyone. Lastly, you see the fault of Krishna. You see the fault of Vaishnavas, you see the fault of Guru, you see the fault of God brothers, you see the fault of Paramparas, lastly you see the fault of Krishna. This is the proof. This is not fault. Krishna is Satya, he is truthful. Where you can find fault? But he's searching, don't find any fault. Ants are moving, then he's shouting, oh, today I came to know, in night time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu eating sweet. Otherwise, why ants are moving? Ants are moving everywhere. It does not mean he's eating sweet. Falsely blaming. But still, Mahaprabhu paying obeisances to him. No, he's... You see, if Guru displays, this is the result. Lastly, you will find out the fault of Krishna. And if Guru flees, take another example. His god brother, Ishwarpuri. You are so humble. So humble. You are serving spiritual master. He is cleaning stool, urine in his own hand. Krishna nama, Krishna lila, karana sravan. And because Gurudev in bed, he is always chanting Hare Krishna and describing Krishna lilas. And Madhavendra Puri becomes so happy.
Tustahaya Puri Tare Kaila Alingana Tustahaya Puri Tare Kaila Alingana Borodila Krishna Tomar Hauka Prema Dhana Baradila Krishna Tomar Hauka Prema Dhana.
And so pleased, Madhavendra Puri so pleased with Ishwarpuri, he just embrace. Tushta Haya Puri Tare Kaila Alingan. So pleased with his service. Krishna Tomar Baradila Krishna Tomar Hauka Premadhan. I'm showering mercy unto you. Let you develop Krishna Prema at lotus feet of Krishna. If Guru shower mercy, then Madhavendra Puri shower mercy. What happened? Krishna became disciple of Ishwarpuri. Krishna became disciple of Ishwarpuri. This is power of Guru's mercy. Yes, Prasadat Bhagavat Prasadat. What to speak of Bhagavad Prasad? The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, came and accept Ishwarpuri as his spiritual master. As, this is the result of if Guru will place. Therefore, Mahaprabhu is saying, Tate Krishna bhaja kare Guru rasevan, Maya jala chute, Maya jala. Jala means net. Maya is just like a net. If someone is entrapped in net, like fish, when he is within the net, you saw fish? For some time, he just try to come out. When he did not try to come out, like that. And just opening mouth like that. We are like that. We are like that. So if fish will try forever to come out from the net, it is possible? Not possible. He may try forever. He can't come out. If we try to come out from Maya, possible? No. Tate Krishna vaje kare Guru Rasevan. So we have to serve our spiritual master. In which way? In devoted Guru Bhaktya. Guru Sushrusaya Bhaktya. With devotion. You saw Mahaprabhu's god brother. Govinda is Mahaprabhu's god brother. Who is personal servant? Mahaprabhu's personal servant's name is Govinda. He is Ishwarpuri's disciple. His guru Ishwarpuri told, when I just left this body, you should go to Sri Krishna Chaitanya, you serve him. Although he is your god brother, you have to serve him. He is following guru's order. We are so degraded nowadays. Even we are unable to serve our spiritual master. How to serve? How to serve god brother? But it's guru order. This is guru order. If guru is saying you have to go to hell, yes, I am ready to go to hell. One story was there. Like yesterday, I was told about what is his name? No, Sivaji, Ramdas. Once Ramdas, he make a same drama. He was such a guru. He was always testing his disciple. So after some days, he's just making a show. That a severe pain is coming. How can you say? Like, how can you say? A lump of flesh is just coming out. He's suffering in pain and shouting. And all disciples come, Gurudev, why you are shouting? Why pain is coming from your body? He said, my pain is coming. I can't tolerate. Such a big, how can you say? The flesh is going up. Swelling is coming out. So, severe pain. Then disciple said, okay, we can treat you. He said, no. Only one thing is there. If someone, because blood is coming out, this is very poisonous blood. If someone will suck this blood with his own mouth, then I will be cured. And be careful, if you suck this blood, you will die. Everyone became fear. Who want to die? Who want to die? And Guru saying, if you suck this blood, I will be cured, but you will die. Then all brahmacharis, all disciples said, no, let Guru suffer. What we can do? This is a disciple. This is a disciple. But one devotee, his name is Amba Das. Later his name was Kalyan Das. He was a very simple guy, but always devoted to his guru, always devoted. He came. When he came to know Gurudev is suffering, if someone suck Gurudev's blood, it is poisonous blood, he may die, but guru, he will be cured. He came. He said, Gurudev, I want to suck. He said, hey, you are a bogus. Guru want to test him. You will die. He said, Gurudev, if I will die, I am a single person. But if you will die, if I will die, there is no loss. But if you will die, 1,000 people will suffer. Let I will die, you should live. This is disciples' mode. If I will die, there is no harm. But you are guru, you are spiritual master, you are giving knowledge to everyone. If you will die, then many people suffer. I am inviting my death, I have no problem. Then he came. Actually, this was not swelling. Then Ambadas came, Kalyanadas came, and put his mouth on that place and start to suck. And falsely shouting, who? Ramdas shouting, oh, severe pain. But he's saying to Ambadas, this is poison. He said, no, Gurudev, this is not poison. This is not poison. The taste is just like nectar. Actually, his guru is putting one mango, ripe mango, under the cloth to test the disciple, he's saying. This is poison, this is poison, this is poison. To test his disciple. How these devotees are serious, disciples are serious. But he's saying, Gurudev, you are told this is poison, this is not poison. The taste is just like ripened mango. Then Gurudev start to laugh and throw out this mango. And said, all you are my disciple, eh? All you are my disciple. You saw, he is my real disciple. They're so dedicated before. Tate Krishna bhaje kare guru rasavan. You can get mercy only by this way. Simultaneously two things, parallel, we can say like parallel. Like a rail tracks. Hindi mein bolte na rail patri. Two tracks are there. It is not up and down, same, parallel, always. You saw railway stops always measuring by their meter, whether these two tracks are parallel or not. You know or not? Same thing. In our life, these two tracks, Krishna bhajan and Guru sevan. Tate Krishna bhaje kare Guru ra sevan. Maya jale chuta pai Krishna ra charan. Then we can free from Maya's net, and we can achieve Krishna's lotus feet. People are so dedicated. People, devotees, disciples are so dedicated. What happened in case of Govinda? One day Mahaprabhu dance. Mostly Mahaprabhu dancing and feeding the devotees, and came and sleeping in doors near the door of Gambhira. And this was Govinda's duty. When Mahaprabhu took rest, Govinda messaging Mahaprabhu's body. And when Mahaprabhu took rest, then Govinda went for Mahaprabhu's remnant. But that day, Mahaprabhu knowingly sleeping in, how can you say, near the door, entrance of the door. And Govinda is saying, Mahaprabhu, please give me way. I want to message you. Mahaprabhu said, no, I am so tired, I cannot move my body. He said, no, I want to serve you. I want to message you. He said, whatever you like, you may do. I can't say anything. Mahaprabhu want to test him. Then Govinda said, no, this is my duty. To serve every day, I am serving. How can today I can stop? So therefore, three types of disciples are there. Uttamam stintita kuryat praktakaritu madhyama. Adhama asradhyat kuryat akarta uccharita pitu. Four type, not three type. Four type son, four type disciple. Uttama sintitam kuryat, like Prabhupada is uttam. There is no necessary to speak. Guru will speak. Guru will order, then you will do. Then you are second class, not first class. First class, what Guru is thinking. If you understand Guru's mood by your sincere prayer, by your sincere service, before Guru saying, if you do this thing, then you are topmost disciple. Praktakari to madhyama. Second one, if Guru is saying, so man is doing. Second one. Third one, mostly in Kali Yuga, third and fourth class. Second class, rare. First class, zero. Third class, praktakari to madhyama. Second class is if Guru is saying, he is doing. Third one, asradhat kuryat. If Guru is saying, he is doing this thing, but no faith. Okay, Guru told me I have to do it. With with hesitation he is doing. And akarta uccharita pitu. If guru is saying someone is not doing, he is like stool of his guru. Fourth one. Rejected disciple. Govinda is first class disciple. He understands mode. Why Mahaprabhu want to test me? You are sleeping just nearby the door. But this is my duty. Every day I have to message. But Mahaprabhu said, as you like, I cannot remove my body. Then he bring one Mahaprabhu's chadar cloth and putting over Mahaprabhu's body and jump to next side and serving. And just messaging and Mahaprabhu wake up. So late, Mahaprabhu said, hey Govinda, why you not taking prasadam? He said, how can I go to this side? How can I jump over you? Then Mahaprabhu saying, how you came? In which way you came, in that way you may go. He said, no, that I can't do. That I can't do.
सेवा लागी कोटिया अपराध नाही गणी सो निमित्त अपराध भासे भय मानी.
फॉर गुरु सेवा, फॉर कृष्ण सेवा, आई मे कमिट थाउजेंड ऑफ ऑफेंसेस. फॉर दैट आई डोंट केयर. व्हेन आई केम टू इनसाइड पुटिंग क्लॉथ ओवर योर बॉडी, इट इज फॉर यू, फॉर योर सेवा. आई कैंट use same formula. Again put one cloth and I can jump over your body for my seva, for my eating. I can't do it, this thing. This is offense. Then Mahaprabhu said, why not you going? He said, how can I go? This is not duty. Mahaprabhu said, how you came? He said, I'm coming like that. Then why not you going? No, this is offense. Then Mahaprabhu stopped his mouth. Mahaprabhu can't say anything. Mahaprabhu want to test. But sometimes his annihilated devotion, his dedication, astonished spiritual master and astonished Krishna. Same story was there. At that time, Ramanucharya staying in Mahapurnasa or Goshtipurna's house. Goshtipurna's one devotee's name is also Govinda. The servant was Govinda. Govinda, after preparing bed, every day sleeping in that bed. After preparing Guru's bed, he's sleeping in that bed. Ramanujaji came to know. Once Ramanujaji saw, after preparing Gurudev's bed, how he's sleeping in Guru's bed? Then he informed to Goshtapurna. Gurudev, he's just sleeping in your bed. Then Goshtapurna just calling to Govinda. Govinda, why are you sleeping in Guru's bed? You know, if someone is sleeping in Guru's bed, what will happen? Yes, Gurudev, I know. For 1,000 lifetime, he will be in hell. He said, you know why you are sleeping? He said, I want your happiness. I am preparing bed, but if I will sleep, then I just again, I am checking that how you can sleep nicely or not. Let I may go to hell. But you can sleep nicely. For that purpose, I am sleeping in your bed. Then Guru became astonished. You are such a disciple. Raman also before complaining. Now he astonished. Govinda is such a disciple. Even he is knowingly, he know I will go to hell. But I want my Guru's pleasure. This is devotion towards Gurus. This is devotion towards Krishna. Is ready in his life to prepare. He is just preparing his life. Even he want to accept curse, but he want Guru's pleasure. This is spiritual life. Tate Krishna bhaje kare Guru rasyaban maya jale chutapai Krishna racharan. Then the net of maya, by their mercy, Guru and Krishna's mercy, we have no power. We have no power. We know what is good, but we can't do it. And we know what is bad. We can't give up it. This is our power. If you want to become strengthy in spiritual life, healthy in spiritual life, want to progress in spiritual life, always we have to pray continuously to acharyas, to serve acharyas, to pray acharyas. This temple is a place of, how can you say, seva yajna. Here every time, how can you say, sacrifice, huh? Fire sacrifice. Like in yajna, always fire sacrifice is going on. Huh? But here also, sacrifice is going on. What is that sacrifice? Seva. Seva yajna. You have to serve spiritual master. You have to serve Krishna. And then Krishna, by their mercy, we can free from Maya. Otherwise, it is not possible. Very difficult, especially in Kali Yuga. So everyone should come to temple and request to authorities, to president, to temple commander, to devotees, please give me some seva. Our Gurudev used to say, if a disciple is not performing seva, he already dead. It is dead body. He has no life. Without seva, if you have no seva, guru seva, that means you are dead. Mercy will not come. Mercy. If mercy will not come, you are dead. We are always saying, give me mercy, give me. How mercy will come? Mercy always come through service. Through service. So please come to temple and be an active member. Active member. Not official member. Just Sunday you can come, take prasadam, then you can go and do your own business. Who will do Krishna's business? Who will do? You don't think this is Prabhupada's temple? Prabhupada is owner. Why devotee is making this temple? For us. So please, always attached to temple. Temple is your home. Your home is not temple. Forget this idea. Your home is not temple. Temple is your home. This is the real shelter place. Prabhupada is giving shelter. So attach to temple, attach to Sadhu Guru, serve and chant Hare Krishna. And you can develop Krishna prem, Krishna bhakti in this life. Hare Krishna. Jai Gaur Nityanand Prabhu ki jai. Jagannath Baldev Subhadra Maharani ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ji Maharaj ki jai. Anand Koti Vaishnava Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. Sambit Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. Thanks. I want to thanks to all devotees, especially our President Prabhuji, our Brahmachari Prabhuji, and all of you. Because my English is not so good. First time I am coming to South India. So, please cooperate each other and serve Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.